To be liberated, a woman must feel free to be herself, not in rivalry to man, but in context of her own capacity and her personality. As said by the Iron Lady of India, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, who in her times unabashedly defied the patriarchal norms to become one of the most successful leaders of the nation. However, there was yet another legacy of strong, powerful matriarchs, cumulatively known as the Begums of Bhopal. Hello everyone, I am Shreya, a student of class 11th, Humanities Stream, St. Mark's Girls, Senior Secondary School. I would love to tell you all more about these radical feminists. It all started in 1819, after the assassination of Nawab Nazir Muhammad Khan, who died without a male heir. In order to save the crown from power-hungry lords, Qudsiya Begum acquired the throne with the help of the British and became the regent until her daughter Sikandar would come of age. Sikandar Begum in 1861 was invested with the exalted order of the Star of India that eventually made her the only female knight in the British Empire after Queen Victoria. She was succeeded by Shahjahan Begum in 1868, who provided large donations for the preservation of Sanchi Stupa and also funded the publications of Sir John Marshall's books that are written on the monument. Even the French and the British took plaster cast copies of the pillars of the stupa to be displayed in the museums of France and Britain. After her, Sultan Jahan Begum ascended the throne in 1901. After a 25-year-long reign that was known for its focus on women issues like health and education came to an end, she became the last Begum of Bhopal, as her great-granddaughter Abida Sultan abdicated the throne in 1948. From funding the Muslim University at Aligarh to establishing a school for girls in Delhi back in 1920s, the Begums of Bhopal believed in the upliftment of women's education and in the creation of an egalitarian society. Courtesy Indian Culture Site. Thank you.